Welcome, and thank you for joining me for the first installment of The Vault, Stan Hewitt Hall Revealed. My name is Julie Fry. I am the curator here at Stan Hewitt Hall and Gardens. This is a new endeavor that's just been created for our members and supporters. This is a project where every week you'll receive an email with a video link where you'll see either myself or another Stan Hewitt Hall employee who will be able to give you insider information, historical tidbits, quotes from the family, information on how the house is maintained even today. This is a way that you as members can get a more behind the scenes look as to the history of Stan Hewitt Hall and the family and also the organization that runs the museum today. So we're so thrilled that you're joining us. Thank you so much for your support. And we look forward to kicking off this new program and providing you with more information about the Cyberlings. I'm standing in the Tower Landing in the Manor House, and over my shoulder is F.A. Cyberling, Portrait of F.A., and I thought this week I'd share a little bit more information into kind of the inner workings of F.A.'s mind. When the Cyberling family built Stan Hewitt Hall and Gardens and moved in December of 1915, they chose to place over the entryway of their home a motto, non nobis solum, meaning not for us alone. And that's really a philosophy that they sought to embody during the 40 years they lived here at Stan Hewitt Hall and Gardens. Their focus really was on giving back to the Akron community, providing not only financial resources, but their time, their energy. They were very focused on making Akron a great community for all of the citizens, not just themselves. So F.A. was interviewed multiple times throughout his lifetime, and this was a philosophy that he not only tried to live out, but he also articulated so that others could hopefully learn from his example and also lead this kind of life. So I'm going to read from an interview he gave to the Akron Times, which was a newspaper in Akron at one time. This was on October 3rd, 1926. What is the greatest thing in life? Is it wealth? Is it big business? Is it mansions? Is it power? Is it fame? Slowly and deliberately, Mr. Cyberling answered, the greatest thing a man can have is happiness. No man can have it unless he gives more than he receives. In other words, doing good as he understands it. That's the thing that counts. The people I can't tolerate are the artificial people. I don't like conventionalists. They are hard to conform to. I have to once in a while, but I don't like it. I abhor a hypocrite. So F.A. really tried to give back to others and to look outward and see what his community needed and think about them first. So thank you again for joining me here for the latest installment of The Vault, Stan Hewitt Hall Revealed, and I will see you next week.